applause, Mr. Mohsen Lodik.
Assalamu alaikum. Can you hear me out? Yeah? No? No or yes? It's a big signal. Last one. Tell me the last one. Okay. Thank you so much. Well, I'm very excited to be among you. I'm going to talk about a topic which is very close to my heart. Turning dreams into reality. Why did I choose this topic? Reason being, everybody has a dream. And especially the budding entrepreneurs, they do have lots and lots of dreams. So I'm going to give you a framework, the basic cardinal rules, how to mature your dreams, because these rules, they are indefeatable. I can talk about the framework which I learned in at INSEAD or other big institute, but I'm not going to talk about it, because it's the basics we need to find out in the first place. What are the basics we do not adhere, and that's why we then fail. And for that matter, I studied the biographies of more than 20 extraordinary people, both in Pakistan and overseas. And I gleaned some experience, and I studied them, and I found out, you know, what made them so successful. So I'm going to, inshallah, share all that experience with you. And before I start that one, can I ask you, what are the basic ingredients which contribute to make our dreams come true?
Passion.
Passion, very good, excellent.
Commitment.
Commitment. اچھا اب آپ مجھے کہہ رہے ہیں آج تک جی سوری موٹیویشن ویری گڈ ڈیٹرمینیشن ویری نائس
کنسنٹریشن
پرپز ویری گڈ ایز جاوید چوہدری صاحب سیڈ پیپل کیم ہیئر دے ٹولڈ یو واٹ ٹو ڈو بٹ دے ڈیڈنٹ ٹیل یو ہاؤ ٹو ڈو اٹ آئی ایم آلسو گوئنگ ٹو ٹیل یو ہاؤ ٹو ڈو اٹ ایز ویل اوکے سو لیٹس سٹارٹ وِد سو موٹیویشن کمٹمنٹ ڈیٹرمینیشن all those kind of things, passion. So let's find out. First of all, dreams, without any action, they remain merely images. So action is the first and foremost thing. I've just met one of my students for the last 2.5 years, and he's still not taking any action, he's still thinking about it. I want to do it. When you say, I want to do it, it means you are interested, you are not committed. Okay, I should do it, then it makes you committed. So in the first place, when you are going to start with, you got to be committed. And action is the first and foremost thing. And then there is the dreams which decide what you want in life. And then is the intentions, they decide how serious you are about your dreams. And that is the determination that determines how far can you go. So I'm going to now start with all those people which I studied, and I'm going to ask you a question. Do you know this person? Anyone? Is it visible, by the way? No, okay, that's not my fault. Anyone? Not at all. Okay, let me share with you who is this person. His name is Monty Roberts. Why did I choose him? Because he's an inspiration for me. And he comes from a very humble background, like most of us would do. And he was the son of a stable man who was trainer of the horses at 1 after 4. And he was born in 1935, and while he was studying at the school, he was asked what he would like to become. And he submitted his project of his dream on 7 pages, drawing the same form where he put his path of walking up 220 acres and he started that game between Tita. And most of the time he used to sleep in this kind of a open bed, a horse truck. And guess what? The teacher, she gave him this kind of a form, you know, he drew. And he said, this is I'm going to own. And the teacher, she gave him not this F, but this F. And then he asked the teacher, why did I get F? And what was the answer? Can you just think about it? As we all do, the answer was, it's a very unrealistic dream. Why? Because you don't have apparently any money, you don't have apparently any resources, you don't have any possibility to reach your goal. With this dejection, he came back home. And what he did was, he discussed this thing with his father. And you know what father said? It's your choice, Monty. Whatever you want to do, just do it, whatever you like. And after a week of contemplation, because he was going to leave, that you need to revise that project. After a week, he went. And you know what he said to the teacher? He said, teacher, you keep your F, and I'll keep my dreams. He excelled. He followed his passion. He followed his dream. And then he had, after a couple of years, the same 220 acre farm. And he didn't stop there, by the way. What made him so distinguished? When you follow the dreams, you become extraordinary. And then he was given awards. In 1996, he was invited by Queen Elizabeth II as a salutation of Sir because he trained her horses. And in 2002, the University of Switzerland gave him honorary degree of doctorate in animal psychology. And in 2005, the University of Italy in Parma, they also gave him honorary degree in animal psychology of doctorate. Even if they didn't stop there, then there were more than three books, but these were the famous one. He wrote them back in 1997, and then 1998 and 2002. And furthermore, when you become famous, this is what happened. BBC and PBS, they made a documentary on him. You know why? Why was he so unique? He did one thing. His dream was, he was not only inventor, he was innovator as well. He developed a language. He was the first of his time. He developed a language through which you can talk with the masses. And that language is called Aquilus. Have you ever heard about it? People can talk with the horses? And for that matter, he has developed a university which is called Aquilus University Online. People go over there, they learn this language. So ladies and gentlemen, when you follow your passion, we do have another person in Pakistan who followed his dream. Mr. Eni, back in 1954, he was simply a compounder working for a medical dispensary. And then he decided to be honest And he said, you should have thought. And I said, how can that be right? The rest of the history. Why? Because he lived larger than his life. And this is what happens. Now I'll tell you, what is the principle behind this thing? When you follow passion, what happens? So most of the people ask me, how can we find out the passion? Because they do not know about it. As Javed Jyoti said, you do have 60,000 thoughts every day. And you have 450 characters built in your side. But you need to find out what is that potential. And what is that? So how can you find out passion? First of all, you need to do what you are passionate about, what you really love to do. And I call this finding the dots. As Steve Jobs said, connecting the dots, I say finding the dots. What you are passionate about, what you really like to do. And not only that one, the second thing is, what you're good at, what people like about it. You might be doing something, but people do not like it. This is Hedgehog principle. And on those two things, the third one is also required. That is your economic engine. It also gives you some money to survive, rather than thrive as well. So this is the principle. It makes you more focused. And most of us, you know, when we start, we have a dichotomy in our thoughts. We are not fully committed. We are not 100%. We don't give 100%. Focus is the name of the game. After the passion, after the dream, when you follow your passion, you got to be focused. It's not only what you have to do, what you not have to do is also very important. Next, the principle now is what we can. The passion creates purpose. It's the passion. When you're passionate about, then it will automatically create a purpose. This is the first and foremost thing. Now you have started and you have followed the passion. What will be the next thing that happens with you while you're doing the business? Can you tell me? Lots of setbacks. होता है कि नहीं होता? Do you know any person who is without failures, who is without setbacks? It does happen. So let me show you. Next one. Who is this person?
Colonel Sanders.
What do you know about him? Yes. What else?
He had failed earlier.
How many times?
31.
Go up. Sorry? 1200. No, it's too much. It's 1009 times his proposal was not accepted. At the age of 61, when he retired from the Navy, in Navy there are colonels, and the friends proposed him, why don't you sell your recipe? And he went to 1009 people. And they didn't accept it. It was the 1010th one. He said, let's do it together. Can you imagine? If we were there, after the second and third one, finish. What do you know about this person? Who is this person? Very famous. Mr. Ray Kroc of McDonald's. Same history, at the age of 54, suffering from diabetes, guess how many people he went to for the sponsorship? 533, it was the 534th one said, let's do it together. So it's not a joke. Then our famous Apple icon, everybody wants to become Steve Jobs. But they do not know what obstacles and tribulations he has gone through. So what do you think about, what do you know about Steve Jobs? Apple? Can you imagine a person who founded Apple after 10 years, whose worth was about $1 billion, he was kicked out only for $1?
If you or me, we were there, how we would have reacted?
We would have crashed.
Crashed, yes.
Billions of pieces.
See? But these guys didn't. And there were 7 megaflops in his life. Not only one, 7 megaflops. Then, last but not the least, you know this person, very famous. Why did I choose it? Because he also came from a different culture. He was born in Austria, Arnold Schwarzenegger. And he didn't have a proper accent. His accent was very odd. And he was not accepted. And his father was always against his building up muscles. He had lots and lots of, as we have in our families, our parents didn't like to do whatever we like to do. Okay? So this is, they went through. So can you just tell me, what is so common in them? What is one unique thing which is common in them?
Dedication.
Persistence.
Dedication.
Persistence.
Very nice. It's the persistence. It's the persistence. And we do have one personality in Pakistan. And have all the rewards for him. I'm sure that you know this person. He's got Master of Ayu. For the last 26 years, he's teaching poor students who can't afford without charging anything. He's teaching them free. For the last 26 years, it's not a joke, sir. Okay, so persistence is another name of the game. If you really want to have your dreams come true, it's the persistence. And then it says that being defeated is often temporary condition. So giving up what makes it permanent. Then you get defeated. So that's the second one. Now, how to become persistent? There's an ant principle, and you know this is the ant. What she does, there's a very good principle about that. It says, fall 7 times and stand up 8 times. This is how you can become persistent. Okay? Now, last but not least, so the second principle is to make your dreams come true. Persistence helps achieving impossible. And you must have seen the Mahmud Ghaznavi 17 times he invaded at Somnath. It was the 18th time. And he learned this lesson from that. See? Okay. Last one. Do you know about the bamboo philosophy? All Chinese bamboo and the Oriental bamboos are grown. Let me share with you, the Chinese bamboo, it takes about 4 years to get its roots strengthened. For 4 years, you do not know what's going to happen. It's the 5th year, it grows and goes from 90 to 100 feet in 1 year. It's shining, it's very strong. And guess what? No storm can defeat this bamboo. Because it's very strengthened. It has a strong roots. On the contrary, our oriental bamboo takes about 4 months, goes about 30 feet. And what happens? With a slight push of a storm, it gets flat. And this is what our attitude is all about. We like to do what? Can you draw any principle from here? And in Pakistan, the gentleman, I have great regard for. I know him for the last more than 20 years. When he admitted that he was a government officer, day 18. Since then, I knew him. But the way he has grown himself is amazing. And the principle is the perspective is important than taking the shortcuts. Shortcuts do not materialize in your dreams. Many temporary, not the lasting one.
Okay? So we have gone through. So there's a law. How can you improve this one? There's a law of sow and reap. It says, there is no shortcut in life. You reap what you sow. So what have you to do? You will just go through that one. So we have all gone through now. If you really want to materialize your dreams, you've got to be passionate about what you want to do. Secondly, you've got to be persistent. And thirdly is, you've got to have the bigger picture. You've got to have the perspective. And at that point, that's the model, that's the framework. And we are all millionaires, by the way. It is what we don't do that keeps us poor. Thank you so much. What question do you have for me? I'll be another 5 minutes. Do we have time? Any questions?